The morning on the mountain, guys. We're gonna glass this basin that we tried yesterday. We're gonna give it one last chance this morning, but it's coming down to the last couple days of my hunt. So if this doesn't work out, we're gonna get in the truck and move up onto another basin. But hopefully we find something here and I can make a stock this afternoon. Things come to an end, guys. It's about 10 o'clock. We've been glassing this basin right here and we saw one doe, but way over by the road. On the backside over here, we picked up a doe and a couple fawns, but that's about it. That's public land hunting though, guys. You don't see something every day, especially going into a new state, not knowing where you're gonna be hunting, trying new areas. So we're gonna try another area up the road. Hopefully we can find some bucks, but this is how our semi-live goes, guys.
Take a look around me. Taking pages from a magazine.
Bloody arrow, guys.
Been looking for the answers ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question. How many times will you learn the same lesson?
Alright, guys, made it back to camp. We load everything up. The nice part about sleeping in the truck is everything goes in the truck. So we only had a couple things in the trash, but now we're all loaded up, ready to go. And then we found on the Onyx maps, we found a little trailer that we're probably gonna take. We're gonna take that up. Probably just gonna sleep in here, probably gonna do any backpacking because we only have a little bit of food left, not a lot of water. But hopefully something happens over there.
A little dust on the bottom, but don't let it fool you about what's inside.
All right, the afternoon hunt is here. We finally made it to that spot we were looking at on Onyx maps. This trail, we're gonna walk till we find a good peak, and then we're gonna glass down on the bottoms and hopefully we can find a buck. The clouds are starting to come in, so I think the bucks are gonna be up and walking around. Let's go, guys.
Which way you think, Anthony?
Need to head up that way. On the Onyx, it says we're gonna hit this trail and it's gonna meet to another trail. And then we should head off over to this little basin. Hopefully there's no people over there and we get it all to ourselves. If it's good tonight, maybe we'll pack in the tent, the sleeping bags tomorrow. But we better get over there to go find out if it's even good.
Alright, guys, we were following that trail on the Onyx maps and it put us right in between two ridges, and I like this ridge right behind us. We had to bushwhack our way all the way up here. Hopefully this basin right here gets some bucks going. I guess Anthony found a spring down here that's flowing pretty good. Hopefully he gets some bucks at track to get some water.
Yeah, that's a marker, so if he works that way, say he's working towards that. I don't know, it's gonna be hard, but you have to lead me to it. You see those two black trees right there? Yeah.
Alright, guys, after a lot of days of hunting, we finally just picked up a nice buck over here. I'm gonna get the bow ready and get ready to make a stock. I'm gonna try to work above him because we think he's gonna work up. And if he works down, I'll just work down on top of him. Let's hope everything goes together, guys. This is why we stay out here and we don't give up. Here we go, guys. Those of you guys who've been following us, it's been a long journey on this Utah hunt. But guess what, guys? It finally all came together.
it wasn't the buck I was going after, but I snuck up and ended up seeing another buck and got within range of him. Shot him at 26 yards, guys. Look at that. We have a bloody arrow, guys. My first mule deer with a bow in Utah in the high country. I couldn't be any happier. I'm waiting for Michael to get down here right now, and then we're gonna go try to trace blood to try to find him.
So Anthony took off after that buck, and he just radioed me and said that a buck jumped on him, and he took a shot, and I guess we got ourselves a bloody arrow, guys.
Still right where I shot the buck. I'm waiting for Michael to make it down here before we start tracking blood. We can't catch a break, guys. It's starting to pour rain, but hopefully it stops and we can start trying to find a blood trail. I think it was a clean shot. Sorry, guys, but I forgot to turn the GoPro on before I let it go, but it all happened so fast. Hopefully we can recover him, guys.
When I was walking down, it actually started raining again. You know us, we never get a break from the rain. But I think Anthony's right up here. Walking up here, I heard we got a bloody arrow. Time to pack out heavy, and for a good reason. Pretty steep hill right here. All right, Anthony. How far was the shot?
It was like 26 yards, maybe
close to 30. Here's the arrow, guys. I don't know, guys. Looks a little red to me. How do you feel, Anthony?
Feel good, man. Smells good. Let's go find him. We'll start tracing him. Hopefully we can find him. Clean pass through, so he should be leaking right now. Let's go check it out, guys. I couldn't be any more excited. This is why we don't give up, guys. We weren't seeing a lot of bucks. We finally spotted a really good buck. I was going after him, but I've never archery'd a mule deer, so I didn't want to pass it up. So here's my first archery mule deer. Guys, we just found my buck. I can't be any more excited. He worked his way all the way down from the top down to the bottom of the trail, and we just found him dead right here. I'm about to go see him for the first time. My first archer kill, guys. I can't be any more excited. This is nuts. I can't explain the feeling, guys. After a tough hunt in Utah, it finally all came together with this buck right here. I couldn't be any more thrilled with him. I was actually working a bigger buck behind me right here, and on my way over there, I jumped up a buck, and he gave me the perfect opportunity at 26 yards, and I let it fly, and it couldn't have happened any better. This was a crazy hunt, though. We were up in high altitude, a miss up there. We worked back down to low altitude. We finally found a trail that we were comfortable with to get away from people, and it all came together.
I wouldn't lie, this Utah hunt was a very rough hunt for me and Anthony, being out of state in our first out of state hunt. But luckily we found this trail and then found a ridge we liked, worked our way up, and then Anthony spotted that buck, made a stalk. Next thing you know, I get a radio and he says I end up having an opportunity at a different buck, took a shot. Next thing you know, we got a buck down.
Starting to get dark, but we finally got everything on the pack, all the meat in the rack. Now it's time to hike her out. We got a long hike ahead of us. Let's get it over with.
The long hike, we finally made it back to the truck. Got the cooler full of meat. Got the rack right here. We're about to put them both on the roof rack and head back into town. Thanks for following us, guys.
Utah hunt's over, guys. Tagged out, couldn't be any more excited. Back on the road, heading home. We gotta stop by Walmart and get some ice. Everything should be good. And then we're off to Idaho. Couldn't be any more excited, guys. Next up to bat, Michael.
I got myself a deer tag in Idaho. Hopefully now I can get full draw and do all the stalking. Hopefully I can plug an arrow and a deer.
It's time for me to go behind the camera and do the work there and let Michael have some fun now too.
Taking pages from a magazine, been looking for the answers ever since we were 17. You know the truth can be a weapon to fight this world of ill intentions. A new answer to the same question: how many times will you learn the same lessons?